Hi viewers, now we are going to see how to install a JDeveloper to develop an OAF application. In this session we are going to cover few topics like finding out the OAF framework version, then downloading from the metalink and extraction to the local folder, then setting up environment variable, and then downloading the dbc file from the server and locating in JDev secure folder. So setting up the default properties, project properties, then creating a simple application, and we are going to run the application and see. Okay, so the first step which is involved in installation of the JDeveloper is finding out a OAF framework version. Okay, so to find out the OAF framework version, we'll have to log into the application. Let's log in into the application. So I'm going to log in into the e-business application. This is Oracle EBS R12. Once we log into the application, in this home page, this is the home page which we have logged in. In home page, in bottom, you can find out about this page. Once you click on about this page, so it will navigate to the this about page, Oracle applications home page. In this page, we can see multiple tabs. So click on technology components. Once we click on technology components, we can see here OAF framework and the version of OAF framework. Here, so this application is 12.1.1 and the OAF framework version is 12.1.1. Okay, so after finding out this, what we have to do is we'll have to download the patch of OAF version which is suitable for 12.1.1. So to download the OAF patch, what we have to do is we will have to log in into the Metalink. Okay, so in olden days it is called to be a Metalink, but so nowadays it's support.oracle.com. Okay, so this is what we call it as a Metalink. So once we log in here, so we can download the OAF patch. To download or to log in into this support portal, so we should have a login. So this login is basically will be provided by the client. Okay, so this login will be provided to the user based on like our client or anybody who purchased the Oracle applications. So they will get a customer identification number. So based on that, the login will be created. Okay, so for in this case, so our application is 12.1.1. Okay, so I have gathered some information. Okay, so the OAF framework version and the patch which is required to download. Okay, so our application version is 12.1.1 and the patch version will be this one, 8431428. Okay, so we have downloaded this patch and this patch is available in my system. So D drive Java, so this is the patch which we have downloaded from Metalink. Okay, so the patch, if you see the 12.1 version, okay, so 8431482, and here the patch 8431482 HR12 generic. Okay, so once we download this patch from the Metalink, so the next step is we'll have to extract this patch to the local folder. Okay, so let's extract this folder here. Okay, this is going to be a extraction of the patch. It may take like 1 or 2 minutes. Yeah, so once we extract this patch, so here the three folders will be generated. Those three folders will be JDAW bin, JDAW bin and JDAW doc and JDAW home. Yes, extraction is completed, and if you observe, there is three folders which is generated, that is JDAW bin, JDAW doc and JDAW home. Okay, so after extraction of patch, what we have to do is, the next step is setting up environment variable. To set up environment variable, go to my computer, right click, properties, advanced system settings, then go to environment variable. Here what we have to do is, we'll have to create one variable. So the variable name should be JDAW user home, and the variable value should be the JDAW home. Okay, so here if you observe, I have extracted the patch in my computer. Okay, D drive Java. Okay, so here we'll have to go to JDAW home and JDAW. Okay, so this is the path which we need to give as a environment variable value. Okay, so once we give that path here, so click on OK, then we are done with the environment variable. Okay, the next step is downloading the DBC file from the server, and we should place that DBC file in JDev home JDev secure folder. Okay, so here to download the DBC file, we need to find out dbc.dbc file path. To find out .dbc file path, again what we have to do in Oracle applications home page, go to about this page. Here we can see one tab, Java system properties. In Java system properties you can find out the DBC file path. So this is what the path of DBC file which we need to download to the local system. Okay, so to download this we will have to connect from the WinSCP and we need to download it. So maybe in some cases you may not be having the access to download the DBC file. You can request your DBA to download the DBC file and give it to you. Okay, so now let's see how to download this DBC file and where to place this DBC file in our local system. Okay, so let's log in to the server WinSCP. Then so provide your host name. Here host name or IP, anyone is fine. I'm going to give IP. Okay, and click on enter. Then here username and password. Once we log into the server using WinSCP, copy that path and go to that path in the server. Okay, so here is the DBC file. Okay, so we need to download it to the local system. Okay, I am going to download it to the some particular location, that is D drive again. Java JDev home JDev and DBC files secure. So okay, the DBC file should be in JDev home JDev DBC files secure folder. Okay, if you see this DBC file is downloaded to the D drive Java JDev home JDev and then DBC files secure. Okay, so we are done with downloading DBC file from the server. Okay, the next step is setting up a default project properties. To set a default project properties, what we have to do is we'll have to open the JDeveloper. Okay, let's open the JDeveloper. Okay, so to open the JDeveloper we'll have to get the JDeveloper icon to the desktop. Okay, so let's get the icon to the desktop. Okay, so here where we have extracted in D drive Java and go to JDev bin, then again JDev, here bin. Okay, and you can find two versions here, two files here. One is JWEXE and JWWEXE. So JWEXE is for something for different operating system, but Windows we will have to use JWW.EXE. Okay, right click on this, send to desktop. Okay, now you can see the shortcut of JDeveloper is created on desktop. Now the next step is open this JDeveloper. Okay, so here it will prompt you to migrate from the previous version. I don't want to migrate anything. Click on no. Yeah, once JDeveloper is open, so what we have to do is before setting up the default project properties, we need to set up a database connection. Okay, so I'm going to include one more step here, like we'll say this as a step 6, then 7 and 8. So step 6 will be creating database connection. Okay, so how to create a database connection? Open JDeveloper, go to connections tab. Here you can find out database, click on database, then click on new database connection. Next, so the connection name I'm going to give my database name. Okay, next, username will be the database username and password is the database user and password. Click on next. Here I am going to give host name as I'll give an IP of my server. Okay, and the JDBC port is 1522 and SID of my Oracle database is InfoDev. Click on next, then click on test connection. So if your database connection is successful, then it will give you the status success, then finish. Okay, so our step 6 is also done, creating a database connection. The next step is setting up a default project properties. Okay, to set up a default project properties, go to tools, then click on default project properties. Here expand this tree Oracle applications, then runtime connection. Okay, so once you click on runtime connection, so you can see and right side the connection and responsibility. Here what we have to do, we'll have to select the DBC file of our server which we have downloaded from the server. Browse, then go to that particular folder. So here it's a D drive, okay, Java, then JDev home, JDev, DBC files, secure, select this DBC file, then open. Okay, next we'll have to give the username. This username will be the application username, so I'm going to give as operations, and the password will be the application user password. Okay, so next we'll have to give the responsibility details. So we'll have to give the particular responsibility of that particular user. Let's say that here operations is having a access to the responsibility called purchasing operations, okay, and we need to give that particular responsibility key. Okay, for purchasing application, the application short name is PO, and responsibility key is purchasing operations. Okay, so if we don't know the responsibility key, we need to find out from, we can find out from the back end, or else we can find out from the front end. Okay, so let's see how to find out from the front end. Okay, we'll have to log into the application. Okay, once we log in into the application, we open the forms. After opening the Oracle forms, navigate to the system administrator. Yeah, once forms is open, then navigate to the system administrator, security, responsibility, define. Here something like we query with the responsibility, so which we are trying to give in a J developer. So it is like, okay, so it is something like purchasing vision operations, the same responsibility key. So I am going to give it here. Okay, so once we give the responsibility key, click on OK, then we are done with the step 7, creating the default project properties. Okay, now we are ready to develop an application. Okay, so now let's see how to create in a simple application, and then how to run that application. So we are going to see. Okay, so to develop any OAF new page, okay, so the basic things what we have to do is we will have to create a new OA work space. Okay, then once we create a new VIO workspace, we'll have to create a application module. Okay, after creation of application module, we'll have to create a page. Okay, so once we create a page, we need to attach AM to this page. Okay, now let's see the first step, creation of VIO workspace. So go to application navigator. Here you can see applications. Right click on applications, then select new VIO workspace. Okay, this workspace file name I am going to give as welcome, then click on OK, next, and we'll have to give the project name. I am going to give project name as welcome PRJ, and so we'll have to give the default package. So this default package will be like the folder path. Okay, info.oracle.apps.po.welcome.prj.web.ui. Okay, this is the the package which we need to give for project, the default package. Okay, then click on next, select this use repository design time, then use the connection which we have created, then click on next. So you can see the connection details which we have given as a default project properties and runtime. Okay, then click on next, then finish. Okay, once we create a new VIO workspace, what happens is here we can see few folders in application navigator. Okay, so this is the project which we have created, and if you expand the tree, we can see the three folders here. So application sources and resources, web content. Okay, now we are done with creating VIO workspace. The next thing is we'll have to create an AM. Okay, so to create an AM, click on resources folder, then right click. Once you right click, you can see here few options. In this option, select new application module. Okay, once we select a new application module, so you will get in a window. So it's like wizard to create an application module, then click on next. Okay, so here one thing we have to do is, this is an AM, we need to change the package, default package to server at the end. Okay, so I'm going to give the application module as welcome AM. Okay, then next, click on next, then so this should be enabled, generate Java files. Okay, so if it is unchecked, then please check it and click on next, then finish. Okay, so we are done with this step also, creating AM. So after creation of AM, what we have to do is, we will have to create a page. To create a page, right click on resource folder, okay, then new. Here, so whenever you click on new, you will get a new window with new gallery. So here select VA components. Once you select VA components, you can see the VA components at the right side. Select page, then click on OK. Okay, so once we click on OK, so it will prompt you for the page name. Okay, we will give this page name as welcome PG. Okay, and this is the web UI, which means like whenever we are creating default VA workspace, so we have given so this path. Okay, then once we click on click OK, so what it will do, it will generate a page.xml file. Okay, so to find out that page.xml file, go to here, expand the application sources sources folder tree, then expand this winfo.orglabs tree, then expand the PO, expand welcome PRJ, next so expand web UI, then welcome page.xml. So this is the page. Okay, whenever we create in a page in Oracle applications, so it will generate in a .xml file. Okay, so now to understand better, so whatever the path which we have given here, okay, so it is going to be like how it is in the Oracle applications server. Okay, let's take an example. Okay, this is the home page. Okay, if you see, if you click on personalize the table or any personalization option here, okay, you can see the document name. Okay, if you see here, Oracle Apps F&E Framework and Home PG. Okay, this is the path of this particular page in a server. Okay, so while creating a page in VAF developer, okay, while developing a new page, we'll have to follow the same folder path. Okay, so how it is there, like Oracle Apps F&E Framework, so this is something like F&E application. Now we have developed here a PO application, like for example, we have developed a like PO application. Okay, that is the reason we have given application short name as PO and responsibility key as purchasing operations. Okay, so now whenever we click on this welcome page.xml, so in downside, so the structure of the page, you can see it. Okay, so this is the pane where we can see the structure of the page. Okay, so then click on main region, then so at right side, you can see the property inspector of that particular region. Okay, so now we'll do some kind of changes to this particular region. So I'm going to change this region ID is something like welcome page ID. Then what we have to do is, as I told you earlier, once we create an AM, then after creation of the page, we need to attach this AM to this page. Okay, now we are going to attach the AM which we have created to the page which we have created. Okay, so to attach this, here in property inspector, you can see BC4J and AM definition. Okay, once you click on this AM definition, so click here edit. Okay, that is three dots. Okay, so once you edit, you can find out the AM which we have created. If you remember, while creating AM, So we have given at the end welcome AM. Okay, select this AM. Okay, so after selection of this AM, we will do some we will give some naming also. This window title will be like welcome, and the page title, so we are going to give as welcome page. Okay, so now we are done with this three steps. Okay, we have created one VoIA workspace. Okay, that is this welcome PR welcome. Okay, and then so in that VoIA workspace we have created one project. Okay, so after that, so we have created one AM and then we have created one page. So for this page we have attached this AM. Okay, that AM is welcome AM. Okay, now let's run this page and see. Okay, so to run this page we'll have to right click on the page XML. Okay, then click on run. Okay, once we click on run, so inside what happens is, so background, this J developer will compile everything. Okay, whatever the objects, whatever the things we have done, so it will compile. So here you can see it as a compiling. Okay, once compilation is done, okay, it should be like without any errors. Okay, so here one thing we'll have to, you know, observe is to run a page, even there should not be a even single error. Okay, and if you see here, it is compilation is completed and zero errors and warnings is 627. Okay, so we need not to worry about the warnings. Warnings can be like 1000 warnings also, it's not going to be a problem. Okay, so even if it is having one error also, we will not see the page. Okay, now this J developer is going to launch the page, okay, which we have created. Okay, so it is started OC4j server. That is something like which we need to make sure that OC4j server is running to run the OAF page from the J developer. Yeah guys, it is J developer launched a Windows Explorer, Internet Explorer, so which will give you the page. Okay, yeah, here if you see, website is found and waiting for reply. Okay, so now we are done. Okay, we have created a simple application, simple page, and if you see, like while creation of the page, we have given the title as welcome, so that is like exactly what we have given in the if you click on this main page region. Okay, and in down, so it when you click on down, when you drag to the down, so you can see the window title as welcome and title as welcome page. So this is exactly what we are seeing here. So this is the welcome page and window name is this one. Okay, so we are done with developing a simple application. Okay, so in this session we have seen, just to summarize, we have seen how to find out a JDeveloper version of a particular VBS to develop an OVF application. Okay, so after that, once we find out the version, so the how to, you know, extract it and how to set up an environment variable. Then once we set up an environment variable, how to download the DBC file and locate in a JDev home, JDev secure folder, then creating a simple page. Okay, so thanks for watching the video, and please subscribe to this channel for more videos. Thank you guys. Bye.